This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, so what we are going to do today is we'll do a hands-on on how to do a VM migration. So VM migration is basically, if you first thing is what is VM, okay? So VM is a virtual machine. Now why we need a virtual machine? So a few of you are experienced guy, so you will be aware of the requirement of virtual machine. So I'll just give a simple example for that. So think like I am a guy who is working on a Windows machine, and then suddenly you give me some work which is on Linux, or which is on let me say Mac, Android, anything different to Windows. So the stuff what I have to do is I have to take off my Windows and I have to start downloading Linux, and I can install Linux and start working. So that's a tedious task. So what I do is, on top of my existing machine, I go ahead with a virtual machine. Okay, now the problem with virtual machine is it will eat my CPU, it will eat my hardware, and it will do everything. But still, most of the companies before cloud came into picture were working on this model only. So there is a website, virtualbox.org, where you get the VMs free of cost, and this is by Oracle. Okay, you have other companies also like VMware, and there are many companies like that who will provide VMs to you, or who will provide virtual machines to you. And on the virtual machine, you can do whatever you feel like. Like you can install Linux, you can install CentOS, Red Hat, or whatever your requirement is. And then you can go ahead with that. And then when you don't need the VM, you can just switch it off or uninstall that, okay? But here in this requirement, what I'm going to show you is that I have a VM, okay? And that VM was running on premises or on my local computer. In a real-time scenario, that was running on a production machine, and now we are migrating that to a cloud environment, basically AWS. So if you want to do this stuff, so what you have to do is, first thing, you have to come to this website, VirtualBox. From here, you have to look for downloads. In downloads, it will take you to host, means where you want to install. So you go for Windows host. So once you install Windows, you will get a .exe file. Okay, I've already done that, and in this laptop I can't do this, but I will do it in a different laptop. I'll show you that in the last. Okay, so I download this thing, Windows host, and I get a .exe file. Then I need an operating system. So let me go for a CentOS minimal ISO VirtualBox. So this is basically the operating system for me. Okay, and from here I can download the operating system. Okay, give me 1 second. I will show you this. I'll connect with a different laptop also, and I will show you all these things. Okay, give me 1 second. I'll mute myself. Okay.
Okay, so I have joined with my different laptop. Now, one second.
Let me mute here.
Okay, so now I am audible, right? Just yes or no on the chat window.
Yes, yes.
Okay, thank you. So what am I speaking? So let me take off this. Now I am here. Go to meeting. Okay, wait, let me become a presenter here. Share screen. Share screen. Okay, now what I'm going to do is, first is virtual box at work. Okay, so if I come to virtualbox.org, you know, I will get a screen like this when it says download a virtual box. Now, because I am into Windows, I will go and download this Windows host. Okay, once I am done with Windows host, I will need a, so this is a host machine or a virtual box. So on this box, I want to install a software, which is basically let me say CentOS or Red Hat. CentOS, go for minimal version, else it will take a lot of CPU. Okay, so you can download anything, and then like any normal installation, you will install and it will start working. Now to save some time, I have already done that. So after everything is done, okay, you take this CentOS Linux DVD ISO. This one is better. So come here and then you will get a virtual machine. So if I type here virtual, so it will open like this. If you click here, it will open a virtual machine. Where is it? Yeah, so it will come like this. Okay, so now we have cloud, okay, and now we have everything hosted on cloud, so there is no problem. But earlier it was not the scenario, okay, or even if they had cloud, it was not that widely used. So at that time when we used to work like this. So at that time when I was doing DevOps, I used to install a VM. On VM I used to install operating systems and I used to work. So now this is something which used to do a lot of trouble to my system. So this system used to be very slow. Still it is slow, but it used to be very slow at that time also. So what I did is that I migrated these stuffs to my AWS cloud. How I did that? So first thing is you should be ready. So this is a ready-made VM, okay? You may get a VM like this, you may not get a VM like this. So you have to create this scenario. If the scenario is not available, you have to create it. In my case, I already had it, okay? So first thing, I have to create a VM. I have to install the required operating systems, and then I have to migrate this stuff to my AWS environment. So that is first requirement, okay? Second requirement is whenever you start a migration, okay, the system should be in power off mode. So I have power off both the machines, okay? Once you are done with that, you come to file and you say export appliance. Okay, means you want to take it somewhere else. If you click here on export appliance, it will ask you which machine you want to export. So let me say I want to export this prod machine. I say next, then it says me that what is the format. So this 2.0 is the latest format, so I'll choose this. And you can choose either OVA format or OVF format. Okay, I'll just now show you what does that mean. So it says OV is open virtualization format, supports OVF or OVA. If you use OVF, all the files will be written separately, and if you use OVA, all the files will be in one place. Okay, so it is up to you whether you want a distributed download or download at one place. Okay, so let me say I say OVF, I want everything at one place, and then I say next, and then if you see, it will start downloading basically. Now if I click here and export, it will start. So it's saying already I have these things. Do you want me to overwrite? So obviously I don't want. So I'll say no, I am canceling this, and I'll show you where I have these contents already. So in my document folder, I have all these things, documents. So I have these things already. So my Jenkins 2.0, I have migrated, which is open virtualization format archive. And I have downloaded this also. This is prod machine, which is virtual machine disk format. So this is VMDK format. We say this is VMDK format, virtual machine disk format. Okay, to port any machine or to migrate any machine, you need to have this format, VMDK or OVA. This is OVA format, this is OVF format. So either way, you need to have a export done. Okay, now this is first part. So I have a VM. In my case, I'm saying I have a VM. Let me cancel this. I have a VM. Okay, I switched off the VM. I exported the VM to my local. Okay, like this, I exported my VM to my local. Now this local VM I have to bring to AWS environment. Okay, how do I do that? Cancel, and let me go to my close. I need this close. Okay, so let me log into my console now. Okay. Okay, my net is little bit slow because it is month end. I have already utilized most of the speed, so it is a little bit slow. I think it is more than that. And one more thing is, I am using VM on this laptop. So whenever you install VM, this is the first problem what you face. Your applications become very very slow, and it will not respond. So this is what is happening right now. And what happened finally, did it? AWS. Login. Okay, I'll just close this because this is making my system slow. Hopefully it works now. Okay, so this is done. Rate your experience. Okay, so this is done. I had the content in my local. So where was it? In documents, I had this content in my local. Now to save some more time, what I have done is I have brought those content to my S3 bucket. So I came to S3. Come on, man. Okay, and I created a bucket and I have uploaded the content. So this is what I have already done. Okay, so whatever I had there, basically the VMDK file and the other content, I have just brought it to my environment, and yeah, it has come. So this is what I have brought to my environment, and this is what I'm going to import or bring to AWS environment. So this is an image basically. Okay, and that to a virtual machine image. This I'm going to convert into Amazon's image, and then I'm going to use it in my AWS environment. Okay, so basically what happens is, today if you talk about AWS, most of the projects, in fact, I'll say 60 to 70% of the projects are migration projects, where you have an existing virtual machine which was running all these days on a virtual machine. You are bringing it to AWS environment, okay? Or you have a database which is running into some other environment. Let me say Oracle, Dell, or for that region, IBM, and they are bringing that to AWS environment. Why so? Because the cost of running these on servers, basically the virtual machine operational cost, is too high. License cost is too high. Okay, people are there from Oracle, they know how costly the Oracle licenses are. Then there are people from IBM and all, they will also understand how costly it is to operate and to work on IBM environment. So what they are saying is, why to run all the applications there? Let me bring the applications to my AWS environment. Okay, so once you bring your applications to AWS environment, you get the benefit of that. And we'll see just now what is the benefit. So you just now saw that I am running a simple virtual machine in my laptop, and it is making my laptop damn slow. And the same thing, I will put it in the cloud, and the same laptop will start behaving normal without any problem. So this is one very common problem which each and every one used to face or is facing when it comes to working with virtual machines. There is slowness, there is frequent disconnection, and there are a lot of security gaps. Okay, so to full, and obviously there is a licensing cost also involved. Now to bring or to make a change, most of the companies are migrating from virtual machine or from VMware to AWS or cloud, where the operational cost is less, security is more, then slowness, then outage is less, and on top of all of these, you pay as you use. Suppose you are running the virtual machine only during daytime, you are paying only for the day. Nighttime you are not running, so you don't pay for that. It's like your electricity. Okay, it is not like whether you use or not, you'll pay this much amount of money. Let me say, whether you use the electricity or not, you'll be paying 5,000 rupees per month. But you will say, boss, I was not there for 15 days, why should I pay? I was not using in the daytime, why should I pay? So the same problem what happens to us when we are living in a small environment will happen, or has been happening, to the big companies when they come to companies like let me say Accenture or some big company like Infosys. So they will always say, boss, I was not using it, why are you asking me money? But they will say, no, it's our terms and policy, you have to pay. So to make some benefit out of that cloud environment, they are migrating to AWS. So this project or this work which I am doing, you can put it in your resume and you can say that I have worked on migration. Okay, and in migration, the work what you do is this only. Okay, I will take the reference from documents, Amazon documents only, and you will see all the stuffs are same only. Whatever we are doing will be same in cloud environment also, in production environment also. The only thing is the volume will be huge. Here we are dealing with a VM which is like 863 MB, it's hardly 1 GB, but there you will deal with a VM which is like 40 GB. One small VM will be 40 GB, big ones will be like 1 TB or something like that. That's the only complexity which you face. Okay, so let me start. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to come here, and this is done. Okay, so now I'll also share one more content. Okay, now before doing anything, now to work with this thing, to do a migration, one very common thing which I need is AWS CLI or command line interface. Now because I am using a Windows machine, I will go with something called PowerShell. Okay, and currently I have my PowerShell is not configured to use AWS. Okay, so when I say AWS configure, it is giving me an error. It says AWS is not recognized as a name. Okay, so what I have to do is I have to install something so that my PowerShell or my command prompt recognizes what is AWS. Now to make that thing happen, what am I going to do is I'm going to come to Google. Let me close this. Come to Google, and in Google I will say AWS CLI This is what I'm looking at. MSI installer for Windows 64 bit. Now, if your laptop is 32 bit, go for 32 bit. But my laptop is 64 bit, so I'll go for 64 bit one. And it will take me to the official page of. So I can go for version 2 on Windows, and I can install that. I guess I have done that. Downloads. Yeah. So you will get something like this, which is AWS CLI V2. If you are installing version 2, you will get V2. If you are installing version 1, you will get V1. There's no problem if you go with V1. Okay, it's a small file of 22 MB. I just now downloaded sometime back, 31. Today only I downloaded some around 4:30 PM. So what you do is just install that. So it's still opening. Now, why I have done all these things? Because to save some time. So it will tell you how to, what is AWS CLI, how to install. Okay. Now, come here. You say installing for Windows and keep on coming down. It says download AWS CLI MSI installer for Windows 64 bit and use version 2. You click here, it will start downloading. Okay, I have done that already. So let me double click here and it will start the installation. Go keep on giving next. And at the end, it is done. Once this is done, say yes, installation is done, finish, and come back to your PowerShell and try it again. Okay, so AWS configure. Again, so let me close this and open it again. So I'll say PowerShell. Now PowerShell will work only if you are in Windows 10. Okay, so let me say AWS configure. Still it says still. Okay, now what I have to do is I have to restart my system. Now if I restart my system, you all will get disconnected. So what should I do? Okay, leave it for time being. I'll do it later. Okay. Now I will do that later. Okay, that CLI thing. Now before that, I want to do one more thing. So what am I going to do is, I will start with my work in AWS. So let me close this. Close. Okay. So what all things I have done till now? I will, one second, I will share it from here. Okay, now if you see the screen, there are steps. Basically, there are some 10 steps which I have to follow. Okay, now come to this thing later. So first step was create a VMDK file from your existing virtual and upload it to S3. So this is I have already done. Download AWS CLI. So this is also I have done, but I have to reboot my system, then only it will start working. So this root credential, this thing is pending. So I will keep a cross here. So step three, I have not done. Then it says create a bucket. So bucket I have already created and I have uploaded the content. So that is also done. Now it says you have to create a role, create a IAM role and name it as VM import. And where will I find the content? I'll find the content here. So it is there in the Amazon document only. I'll just go and figure it out quickly. So back here. So if I have to create a IAM, what am I going to do? I'm going to come to, if I have to create a role, I'm going to come to IAM. So I'll come here, I'll say IAM. Meanwhile, I'll also look for this command. VM import from Amazon Docs. The thing is that this migration thing is happening so frequently that even Amazon has come up with the documentation where it says step by step what you have to do, how you have to do, and what is the best practice. So there is something called docs.amazon.com VM import latest user guide, VM import image import HTML. Okay, I will give this link to you people also so that you people can go through this. Now if I come here, it says import your VM as an image. So this is what we are trying to do. Okay, we have just now created an image and we are trying to import this. Now it says there are some prerequisites. So let me come here. What are the prerequisites? So it says create a S3 bucket for storing the exported image or choose an existing bucket. So the first thing is that you have to create a bucket and put your image there. So if you remember, I've just now shown you that. Then it says create a IAM role named as VM import for the information C required service role. So let me come here. So it is saying create a IAM role and use this. So let me open that. Okay, meanwhile I'll come here and it says role. So I'll come on role. And I'll create a role. And if you see the document, it clearly says create a IAM role named as VM import. So please make sure that you don't change the name, because then if you change the name, things will not work. So who's going to use it? Obviously EC2 is going to use it. Permission. So here you have to, so you can give this guy administrative access. Okay, he will need any questions. Guys, any questions? Somebody, okay, my voice is not clear. Okay, so I have come closer to my system. Okay, so what am I going to do is I just said that I will follow this document. Okay, the first prerequisite is already done. It says create Amazon S3 bucket. So I've created a S3 bucket and it says store the exported image or choose the existing bucket. So either you create a new bucket or you use the existing bucket, but go ahead and keep your image there. Done. That's done. Then it says if you don't know how to create a bucket, you can use this and create a bucket, but I know how to create a bucket. Second thing it is saying is create a IAM role and put the name as VM import. Now this is mandatory that you give the name as VM import only. So let me come here. It says required service role. So I've clicked there and it will bring me here. Now it says you have to create IAM role, but you have to add this in the trust policy.json. Okay, what is that? I'll just now show you. So if you come here, don't give any policy as of now. Come to the next section, say tag, and give a tag. Let me say name VM what I have, VM import only I'll give, and review. Here the name is same, VM import, description same. Currently no policies, I've not attached any policy. Okay, create role, I am simply creating a role, I'm not attached anything. So let this role get created. Now let me come and look for that role, come inside the role. Now if you see here, there is something called access advisor. Okay, click on this access advisor. Back to my document, it says trust policy JSON. So this is what has to be kept there. Now why I was telling you that the name should be VM import, because here in the document they have used VM import, and internal setting is also done in such a way that only VM import will work. So please take care or keep that thing in mind. So let me come here. In your trust relationship, say edit trust relationship, there will be a existing document. Just take off and paste the one which you just now got from here. Okay, I'll show you again the same thing. Okay, it says create a file trust.policy.json on your computer and add the following. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to simply copy this content. First thing, how I came to this page. So I was here on this page. So I just, what I did in Google, I typed VM import for Amazon from Amazon Docs. That's it. Came here to this link. I will share all the links with you. Okay. Links are not the problem. Where to go, what to do is what you should know. Again. Okay. So it comes here. Okay, in the PDF format, I come down. What are you going to do? I'm saying I'm importing a VM as an image. Click here. Okay, come down. It gives you a prerequisite. In prerequisite, the first thing is S3 one, which is I have already done. The second thing is IAM role named as VM import. And for more, it says C required. So I right clicked on that and I came to this web page basically. Here it is giving me a trust policy.json. I'm copying this content and I'm coming here and I'm just changing this. So I say update trust policy from where I came to this. So I have just now created a role. I clicked on create role and I created a role called VM import. As of now, I have not attached any policy. Okay. Remember, I'm not attached any policy. VM import. If I come here, okay, there is something called trust relationship. Come here, edit trust relationship and copy paste the content from here. This is the one which has to be copy pasted. Done. So the first activity related to role is done. Okay, guys, any doubt till this point of time? Any questions, any doubt, anything? So first thing is you should be clear of the agenda. Like, what are we trying to achieve? So the first agenda is that we have a virtual machine which was running somewhere in your local, or it was running in some company's machine, some server was running somewhere. Now that server or that virtual machine is what we are migrating from outside world to AWS environment or to cloud environment. This is the agenda, or this is the work what we are doing. Okay, to make that thing happen, the first thing what I did is I created a VMDK file. How I created that, I've shown you. Okay, in the video, you can go again and see that. I created a VMDK file. Why I have already created and kept it? Because these are time-taking process. Okay, so minimum 1 hour or half an hour it will take. So I've already created those files, which are basically like this. It will be either a OVA file or OVF file. If you go for OVF, you get something like this VMDK format. If you go with OVA, you will get something like this. Okay, it is up to you which format you choose. Both are supportable, both will work. Once I have these contents, what am I going to do? I'm simply going to come to my AWS, to my bucket, and upload the content. That's it. First two activities done. Then I come to my management console here. I just create a a role. So I have created a role. Now till this point of time, any doubt, any questions, please let me know.
Sir, for every data transfer we use the same memo, like VM import.
No, not for everything.
No, actually, like if we change the name, it won't work. You said it won't work.
For this one, okay. Come to the document. No, you have, see, there are so many types of. I am doing an image import. There can be an instance import, snapshot import. Now, snapshot is, if you remember, it is related to your database.
Yes.
Okay. So depend on what you are migrating, you have to choose. So I told you that I am doing an image import. VMDK is nothing but if you see here also, VMDK is nothing but virtual machine disk format, which is an image, okay, outside world image. It's not AMI, it is an outside world image. So that I am bringing to AWS environment. So if you are using image import, then you use this. If you do instance, there's slight difference, 95%, 98% will be same, slight differences will be there. Okay.
Okay.
Now, is that policy file same for any type of migration? No, it is not same for every type of migration, but mostly it will be same. Okay, any more questions? Guys, I'm expecting questions, because if you ask questions, I feel you are like understanding little bit.
Yeah, Vikas, this is Arun. So here please today we are configuring anything VMware. We are just uploading the file VM import and creating a role for it, right? That's what we are doing here.
No, no. See, the agenda or the end result is that something which was running outside. Okay. See, what I said is why cloud came into picture. So you can mute yourself. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So what I am saying is the very first day when we started the class, we told that if you are there with VM, things were there before cloud came into picture. Okay. Then people started moving to cloud. Now, before people were moving to cloud or before cloud even exists, all the applications were working. Everything was doing fine. And how we were doing it? We were doing it with the help of virtual machines. There were some very big companies like VMware, okay, Oracle VirtualBox, which were making hell lot of money with this business. They say buy servers. If you don't buy servers, buy VMs from us, okay, and run your application on that. So if there is an experienced guy in this group, he will tell you that it's such a pain to work with VM. Virtual machine basically, because the frequent disconnection, most of the time it will be, you will not be able to connect to the machine, then it will be very slow. You, if you run one click, it will go like ages. So there were a hell lot of problems, but we did not have an alternative at that point of time. So nobody migrated, but today we have an alternative, which is cloud. Okay. So the purpose of this demo or the purpose of this project, what I'm showing you is that how we do migration is what I want to show you. So if you are looking for a role in AWS environment, like a cloud engineer or a cloud architect, 90% probability is there you'll be asked to work on a migration project, because currently everybody is migrating to cloud. So end result of this session is that you should know how to migrate. To migrate, there are certain steps. Yes, those are standard steps, which will be more or less same for everywhere. If you do a VM migration, or you do a database migration, or you do a migration from Azure to AWS, or anywhere to anywhere, more or less it will be same only. But my agenda is to show a image migration today. That is what my agenda is. Hopefully I have answered your question.
Yeah.
Okay. Anybody else with any other question? Okay, then I'll move ahead. So I have this thing ready. As of now, I have not given any permission. Okay. So it is saying attach policies. Now, before I give any permission, I'm going to create a policy. Okay. So I can directly come here, say attach policy. And I can give him admin access. First thing, apart from admin access, I want to give him one more access. So I will say create policy. And let me go ahead and create a policy. Okay. So let me come to this thing. So here. So here only, if I scroll a little bit down, it says create a file called role-policy and use this. No, not this. And here you have to change the bucket name. Okay, which bucket are you going to put the content? So this two places you have to change. Basically here also you have to change export bucket. Okay, you have to change the bucket name. Okay, disk image file bucket. So it says, is it open? Okay, here I will use JSON and I'll go back to this place. It says create a file name. So I'm going to create a policy with this name. And where is the disk image name? If there is a disk image bucket name, I will change it with my bucket name. And for export bucket is the bucket for exported image. Disk image file name. One second. So I'll copy this thing, entire thing till here, control C, and I'll go and paste it here. Okay, control V. Now here I have to change this a little bit. So I need the bucket name. Okay, so export hyphen bucket. So I need the bucket name. I'll replace it here. Now to make that thing happen, I will go to my S services. I will go to S3 and I will take my bucket name from there. This is the bucket name basically. Let me click on this. Copy the bucket name. This is the bucket name basically. Let me copy the name, control C. Come back to management console. Here I'll change this. Okay, export hyphen bucket. Let me give my bucket name, control V. Same here, control V. Okay, now if I go here, it says disk image file hyphen bucket, and this has to be changed with. Okay, it says where disk hyphen image file bucket is the bucket for disk images and for exported images. Okay. I think I have to change all. I will change this also with the same name only. Control V. Control V. Okay, I'm done with this. Let me save this. So I will do a review policy and I'll say create policy. So to create policy, I need a name. So I'll go here and I'll take this name only. So here it says role hyphen policy. I'll take this. Control V, control V, and you say create policy. So I've created a rule. Okay, I've created a policy and I've created a S3 bucket. So let this policy get created. Okay, this policy got created. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to give him administrative access. Okay, oh no, I'll come to my role first. Role. My role was VM import basically. So I will come and look for my role, or I can come like this, VM import. Okay, go inside, attach policies, give him administrative access, also give him the access which you just now created. Say attach policy. So it will say that you are giving two access to this guy. One is your role policy, which you created, which is a managed policy, and one is administrative access, which is ready made. Are you okay with that? So say, yes, I'm okay with that. So it says to policy has been attached to VM import. So I'm done with the step of creating a user also. Okay, I'm done with that. So now what I'm going to do is, okay, so let me close this, come here. But then there is something which is optional, I don't need that. Test policy. Because I made a small mistake. What I've done is I've copied a wrong this thing. I should have copied this policy basically. I am user wala policy. I've copied a different policy. I'll go and change that once again. Let me copy this again. Basically, I'll tell you what mistake I have done. I was to copy this required in the same page only, in the same page only, where I was saying trust policy.json. No, I copied a wrong this thing. So this is not the one which I'm looking. I copied this third one, but I was not. But I don't need that. I need basically this. So what I have to do is Control C. I have to come back to IAM, and in the policy, in the role policy, I'll just come and edit that. Okay. So let me come here, say edit policy. And say JSON, say Control A, delete everything, and Control V here. Yes, this is what I have to change, my S3 bucket and my S3 bucket. This name is what I have to change. So one second, Control Z, Control Z. Let me just take the bucket name from here, vmdk-backup2020. So I'll take this thing with me. See, I'll put it in a notepad. Then I'll come back here. Control C, I'll come back here. Control A, Control V. I'll come here and I will change this. So this is what I have to change. List all my S3 buckets, that is okay. These two places, my S3 bucket, instead of that, I will give this Control C. So Control V. Control V. Now review policy, save changes. So this is done. I think the changes is saved. Let me refresh. Let me see if I'm seeing the latest one. Yeah, I'm seeing the latest one. So this is changed. So accordingly, everything has been changed now. Now, so I will, I see that it can, it is heavy. So what I will do is I'll break into one more class. I'll take one more class and the rest I will do there only. Okay. Just before leaving, I want to do one thing. Last thing I want, I'll create a file, which is container.json, and I will keep this content. Okay, what am I going to put there? I'll just now show you. So this, I'll come to my local. I will create a normal text file. One second. So what am I going to do here? I'm going to create a file which is container.json. So I'll say new text document and I will do control S. Now if I open this, it will open as a text, but what I'm going to do is I'll say file save as container.json and I will make this as all files save. Yes. So refresh. So I have a file here which is container.json. Let me just see the properties. Not this, wait. Shift delete. Okay, file save as control V container.json and I will make it as all file and I'll save it. Now this is okay. So this has become like this container.json. I'll come here, I will open in Notepad++ and I will copy this content. This content, the following example of this thing. So just take this, control C, paste it. Here you have to change few things. Okay, so what is this? Is it you can give any description. Okay, so my, I will say production machine, something like this. I'll give, okay, it is up to you. You can give any this thing. Then what type of format is this? So if you remember, I'm using a VMDK format, I'm not using OWA format. So I'm using OVF. So for OVF, you write VMDK. Okay, then it says S3 bucket. So what is your bucket name? So if you remember, I have the bucket name here. So this is my bucket name. Bucket name. What is the file name? Okay, this is nothing but the file name. So if I come to my S3, or I will come here only, I'll get the file name from here also. So this is the file name basically. So I'll do F2, control C, and I will give this name, control B. Okay, so I will just revise what all things I have done now. Okay, and then tomorrow we'll resume from here only. So let me first come to this place. Okay, so my target was to import a VM, okay, as an image using VM import. So this is what I wanted to do. So I told you what is a VM first thing. So VM is nothing but if I come here, if I, because I have already installed a virtual machine on my application or on my laptop, I can show you what a VM is. So let that VM get open first. So this is a VM. VM is something which is virtual machine. Why do you need a VM or why do you need a virtual machine? On Oracle, sorry, on Windows machine, I want to work with a different operating system like Linux or Shell, CentOS, Red Hat. So I install a VM. So here, if you see, I'm working with Red Hat 64 bit. Here, if you see again, I am working with Red Hat 64 bit. So if you want on a Windows machine to work with some different machine, then you install a VM. There are problems with VM. VM in one line will make your system very, very slow. So what I do is I plan to migrate this to cloud. So file, export, choose the machine. Next, choose OVA or OVF, up to you. Choose 2.0 and say next. The moment you say next, it will start the export. Export means at the end you will get files like this. I have done for both machines, Jenkins machines also, production machine also, both I have done. So you get, so this is a bigger one, around 4 GB, and this is around 850 MB or 900 MB. So I'm showing you this one. What I did is I created, one second, I created a S3 bucket, and I have brought, or I have just imported all the content, whatever I had, to my bucket. Okay, in my bucket, once the content is there, I'm okay with the content. So one part is done. Then I come to IAM. In IAM, go ahead and create role. I take help of Amazon document, which is this. I will share the URL with you. In case you yourself want to look into that, just come to Google, say VM import for Amazon Docs. You'll get this. That's not a big deal. Okay. So it comes to place. Here, if you come first, take it to prerequisite. Please move. Okay, so I come to a place where I see importing this thing. I choose image import. I come down, and there it will show you. I'll click on image import, and I come down. There is something called prerequisite. I start with prerequisite. So it says create a S3 bucket and go and put your content there. That I have done already. Okay. Then it says create a IAM role and give a name of VM import for other. What to give in the role, you come here. So that also I have done. So I came here. Service role, VM import. And this is what I have to change in the trust advisory. So this is all. Also what I have done. So roles, in role I will just that's the problem with this machine, it is very slow. So I've created a role called VM import, and in VM import I have given this in the trusted advisory. Change this first thing, that is done. Then it says go ahead and create a policy. So I created a policy. To create a policy, I need this thing, required permission for IAM user. Here I need to change one thing, which is nothing but I have to change this highlighted in red. I have to change it to my bucket name. So I changed that. I created a policy, and then I also attached those two policies, basically the administrative access and the one which I have. So if I come here, it will show me both. The role which I created and administrative access, both I attached to this. So my role is ready. My S3 bucket is ready. My VM has been exported. And at the end, I created a JSON file, which is this. Why I need a JSON file, I will tell you later. So this is what I have done. So basically three steps I have done. All the steps, other steps I will do later. Now, please go ahead if you have any questions.
Sir, actually in virtual machine we have migrated the image data, right? Hello?
Not only the data, the entire machine we have migrated.
So like here in
Go ahead.
So we have migrated, and if we have migrated entire data, means like in Amazon, we have only migrated the image and image versions, right?
No, no, no. See, VM, you can think like is a machine, okay?
Okay.
Just let me show something like this. Wait. VM.
Okay. Okay. If you see this image, okay, this one. So this is a VM, okay. So there is something called host operating system. There is something called hypervisor, okay. And there is infrastructure. So infrastructure is your own local laptop, local operating system. For me, it is my laptop and Windows operating system. And then something which is connecting your VM to your host operating system. So this entire thing, application, bin, guest operating system, all the thing I have taken and I have brought to AWS environment. So this is what I'm actually talking about.
Okay.
Got it.
Mm-hmm.
Host operating system and infrastructure, it stays with me. Apart from that, everything I have taken to AWS environment.
Yeah. Okay. So, but the thing is that we have migrated the images, right? Images in Amazon. Like you said, you have selected some images.
Correct.
So that means like we have downloaded the entire bulk of data, and how we can migrate only images.
That is how it is. When you, that is how the stuff is designed. See, here only it's a export appliance. So this is what it is. It says that you can get, you can take everything.
No, how it got separated? I'm asking like how it got separated, like images or videos or any data. Or how it got separated?
This is a software only. It is not something which is inbuilt. So if I come here, see virtualbox.org. So this is a software only, which I have downloaded from virtualbox.org. So this is a software. On the VirtualBox is nothing but it's a software. On that software, on the software, I have installed something that it's a VM.
Okay. Okay.
Because it was taking the current working system image, or how it works, fresh image. Suppose the virtual machine is already running on some application.
No, no, it is taking the entire image because I am stopping it here. I'm stopping the machine and I'm saying whatever is there, you take everything. It's not the latest backup or anything like that. The entire machine I'm talking about.
Okay, so I think it's a completely creating the ASO image. That is what.
Yes.
Present running.
Yes.
Present running OS.
Correct. Everything. Present running and backup. Everything.
Okay. And because if it is a one VM having 100 systems, 100 machines, how we can go for that one? We have to go one by one, one, or it's a different way.
So you can run it in a batch. I'll show you that. In the documentation only it is there, but you can run it in a batch, one by one. It will go one by one only, but it will. You don't have to do manually. It will go as a batch.
Sir, we have not migrated entire thing, right? Like we have only migrated the image part of that virtual machine. That's it, right?
Okay. See, tomorrow in the class, I will show you what we have migrated. I have a, like in the Google, there will be diagram. I will show you what we migrate. So you're getting confused. Can you? Okay.
Yeah, I'll because I am having
a share the recordings with you. Okay. Yeah, please.
Because I am having a question. See, if I am migrating the physical server, if we are migrating, do we need to take the full image or do we need to convert the image to any other format?
No. See, there are different formats available. Okay. So if I'm going with VirtualBox, they give me two formats basically here, which is OVA and OVF.
Yeah, but that I understood.
VMware, no, they give a different format.
but at the end it is an image, ISO image, we can say like that.
Yeah, that okay. One is correct.
So whatever the image is, you don't need to worry on the extension of the image. The process is same.
Okay.
You come to your VM, say I want to export it, bring it to your local, from local bring it to your S3, from S3 Amazon will take care. The proper roles have to be defined. It will go and take care of other things. Got it?
Yeah, okay. If the snapshot is there,
so
that directly can we migrate? For that also do we need to change the extension of the file?
For that you need role. The proper role has to be there. Without role you can't work. So see here, there you can go for a snapshot. So if you have a snapshot, basically you're talking about a database. So you can go for a snapshot, or you can go for an instance, export from another instance. You can go for an AMI. So there are various what you can say types of images, I can say.
Okay, tomorrow process also. Hello.
Yeah, I'll show that also. That's not a big deal. But the only thing is, it will take time. But that's okay.
No, one leaf from this one. AWS, how to export the this one machine.
I can show you that. Not so big deal.
Because if we are importing and exporting, it will be a chargeful, right? For the basic. AWS.
If you are exporting, importing, it will be.
Is it chargeable for that AWS?
Obviously, it is chargeable. It is chargeable. Yes, it is chargeable. 100%, it is chargeable. But you can try it. It will not cost you a lot of money. Okay, fine. I'll close this call and I will share the recordings. Please do this much, whatever I have done. Later we'll do in the next class. Okay,
Vikas, share the recording with us.
Yeah. Okay, man. Bye-bye.